Hi, welcome to my channel. My name is Kinyere. If you are on my channel for the very first time, then I'm guessing you like videos like this and I enjoy doing videos like this. So this one is going to be a really interesting one. This is going to be very, very helpful. All of these things I'm going to mention, I might not be able to give you all links, but at least when you see these things and you step out, you have an idea of what to look for. Or if you're going online, you know, online shopping, you have an idea of what it is that you're looking for to solve a particular problem. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys 10 things that I think are really, really helpful. They are very small items and I'm going to use the word cheap. Okay, I hardly use the word cheap because I feel like cheap is very relative. Of course, you may not really know that you need these things, you may not know how important they are until you start actually using them, and then you're like, what was my life before these things? So I'm going to let you know that it has taken me a while to compile these things because I initially never planned to do a video like this, but then over time I realized these things were so important. And then I'll start thinking, what was I doing before I actually purchased this thing? Like, how was I even surviving? How was I even going through life on a daily basis without having this thing? So it took a while to just compile, and I'm happy that I could at least compile 10 of these things and share with you guys. So the very first thing on my list is a door stopper. Of course, it doesn't apply for everybody. Not everybody has doors that stay open or doors that will shut when you're trying to keep them open. So with door stoppers, you can use them when you're stepping out and you want to keep your door open, or when you want to open your door just a little bit. You don't want it open too wide, you don't want it open too narrow. The one I had was very cheap. I think I got it for 500 naira, and I like that it's made in the shape of a foot, even though I wish it was a different color, like black or white, or you know, off-white or cream, but like a neutral color. But then they have a lot of them on Amazon. I'm going to try and leave links to the one I found on Amazon. That one is really beautiful. They have the ones they make from wood, but mine is made from plastic. So, and I found mine in a store around me, and it was for 500 naira, so it was really, really cheap. Don't be one of those people that use sneakers or use their dustbin or use a bedside drawer or just use some kind of heavy objects to leave their doors open. It doesn't look good, it doesn't look cute. So you can get yourself a cute door stopper. You know, you can even spray paint if you feel like you get one that doesn't match the color of your door. You can spray paint it so that it looks like it came with the door. And not everybody's opportunity to have those ones that you know, fit into the ground in hotels. I don't know if people make houses like that, but I'm guessing not a lot of people have, you know, the luxury of having that. So this is also a good way to solve that problem. Another thing that I absolutely love are command hooks. I love command hooks. My major problem is the fact that whenever you go to purchase them, especially here, the stores we have here, most times you get the ones that don't hold up for a long time. And depending on where you put them, you would get long use out of them. If you use them in your kitchen a lot, they don't last the longest in the kitchen because of all the heat and all the moisture. It just kind of weakens the adhesive behind it. If you use them in rooms where you don't have a lot of heat and you don't have a lot of moisture, then they tend to last longer there. But I really like command hooks. You can use them to hang up frames if you don't want to bore holes into your walls. You can use them in the kitchen. You can use them to hang up your utensils. But the one thing I like to do is whenever I go into a store, they are really cheap, so it's easy to buy as many as possible. Usually when I go into a store and I find a pack that I like, when I bring it home and I, you know, test it and I see that it's really strong, when I go to that store again, I tend to pick up the exact one or the exact brand, maybe in a different design if I don't find it in the design I got before. So a lot of times it's a hit or a miss. You could get one that will last you for a really, really long time. I've had some of them that won't go off the wall. Even when I want to take them out, they don't just go off the wall very easily. And then I have some of them that I'll put up and then the weight of the thing I put on them, I don't even put heavy things on them. That's even the most annoying thing. I have those ones that I put like the lightest things on them, and then they just fall off after a while. It's also a good way to manage space. So if you have a cabinet and you have, you know, the walls of the cabinet are empty and you don't want to have to put some of those things on the cabinet or in the cabinet, you can hang them up or hang them at the side of the cabinet. You can hang up things like baking trays, measuring cups, like I said, measuring spoons, you know, light items, and you can just hang them up on the side. It saves you space as well. Another item that I really, really like and I'm really enjoying is this window duster that I got from a store on Instagram. I'm going to leave her store name in the description. I've mentioned her handle a couple of times in my vlogs because I buy a lot of home stuff from her. The best way to use it is to clean your my window net, and that's what I use it for, to clean my window net, especially when I have a little bit of dust. But it's not the best thing to use when you have so much dust, like during the Harmattan season. But you know, frequently, once a week, once in 2 weeks, you just use it and just clean off the dust from your net. I love how soft it is. And I also use it for, you know, hard to reach areas if I don't want to climb, because I mean, these are places that you can climb. But then if you're just doing very minor cleaning here and there, you can use that. I use it to clean the top of my ACs, I use the top of frames, you know, just those areas I know I might not want to climb up to reach, or I don't want to climb my sofa to reach. You can use that. The good thing about it is it is adjustable, and you can also wash it. So you just take it off, throw it in the washing machine, spin it and put it back on. It's been so helpful, especially with windows. I am very particular about my windows, and so I clean my nets very often. And I notice that sometimes when I want to use like a cloth and then water to clean, sometimes it's too, I feel like I'm putting a lot of pressure on it and I don't want to rip the net. So with this, I just use this to clean when I have to clean once in a while, and I'm not doing like deep clean. So the fourth thing on my list are microfiber cloths. I love microfiber cloths. I cannot do without microfiber cloths at all. So the thing about microfiber cloths is that they are not like regular cloths. I have come across microfiber cloth that don't absorb water as much as they should, you know, the kind of cloth that you would use to clean, and then when you take it off, it just kind of drags the water across the place and it doesn't absorb it. So if you are buying microfiber cloth, if you can feel the texture, it's also important. They feel almost like towels. I've had bad luck with microfiber cloths, I think like once or twice. The ones I have now, I think I got from ShopRite, and I think I got from another mall, so other small in Ikeja. You will come to my kitchen and not find a microfiber cloth on my counter. That's what we use to clean our counters, dining, that's what we use to dust. I have an extra one that we use to clean shoes, and I use them for a variety of things. You can use them in your toilet if you're washing your toilets and then you need to clean your mirror, or you know, you need to mop up water. I have microfiber cloths everywhere. Another thing about microfiber cloths is that they don't leave lint behind. I have bought microfiber cloth from ShopRite that I've used to clean, and then once you clean, you just see it just leaves so much lint. So you're cleaning and then you're trying to clean off the thread and all of that. So if you find good quality microfiber cloths, you don't get them leaving lint behind. I use them to also clean my sofas, because I mean, you can't be living in a house and sitting on your chairs, and you have visitors coming to your house, sit on your chairs, and you're not cleaning your sofas. So one of the ways I use my microfiber cloth is once a week, I just soak a microfiber cloth in water and soap. I squeeze out the excess water and then I use it to clean my sofas. It does such a good job, and when the sofa dries, which is probably in the morning, because I do this at night so that my sofa can dry, and then in the morning you come out, you don't see those marks, you don't see those patches. So it makes things very easy and it makes it really enjoyable as well. So another thing that I find so helpful and so useful is something that I picked up from my mom. As a child, we had this red brush and dustpan. I remember so well because we used it for so long and we ended up throwing it away when it was already like dead. I think maybe the handle of the dustpan was falling off from the body. But then even though we had brooms, like a regular African home would have brooms, we had that brush and dustpan. And I remember my mom would always tell us to use it when we eat biscuits and we need to clean up after ourselves. And we'll just, you know, it's very easy. You just bring it out, whip out the brush, and then you just brush. It's easier to use than a regular broom. And so I remember that we would eat, and then when we need to clean up after ourselves, we'll pick up the brush. And if you're still young, like young, and you haven't gotten a hang of using a broom, you'd always go for a brush and a dustpan. So this thing has just followed me from me being a child, and now that I'm an adult and I also have it, it's a good way for me to teach my children to clean up after themselves, because of course they have snacks, and then sometimes it might not even be their snacks, it might be that you want them to clean up an area of the house and you might not want them to get brooms or to use brooms. It's a good way to get them involved in cleaning up the house. It's easy, it's small, they can bend, they don't have to stand on like they would when they use a broom. And I love this brush and dustpan set. It's sold everywhere, you can find them in stores. I feel like it's something that everybody sees. We use them to sweep sofas. They can also get into corners and like bring out all of that dirt. Another thing I use the brush and the dustpan thing from are my windows. Even though you cannot bring out the dirt completely from like your window, what they call this? Should I call them window tracks? I think I'll call them window tracks. It's also a good way to at least pack the dirt to one side and then maybe use a rag to like scoop out. You can use them to clean nets because, you know, the brush bristles will go in through all the holes. So if you have net doors or screen doors, you can also use them to just clean your nets. So this next item is something I have in every room in my house, apart from my living room and my dining. But I have in my kitchen, I have in all the rooms in my house, and I have in all the bathrooms. So these are behind the door hangers. I don't know what to call them, but I'll just call them behind the door hangers because I use them behind the door. I don't think they are cute when you use them in open places. They're a good way to hide your mess. So I know that a lot of people have that chair. That one chair where they dump all their clothes. You come back from work, you dump your clothes, you're going to bed, you probably dump what you wore at home. You wake up in the morning, you dump your PJs, you wake up and you come back from work, you continue with the pile, and then your stuff just keeps on piling up. I don't do that. Never done that. Will never do that. The best and the easiest way to do this is to put a hanger behind your door and hang up your clothes. I know that sometimes you wear clothes, they are not dirty, they're not too dirty to go into your laundry basket, and they're not clean enough to go back into your wardrobe, and you probably want to wear them again. Just hang them up and let them air dry. You can also use them in your bathroom to hang your towels, to hang your underwear, to hang your clothes, whatever you want to hang. So they can take up a lot of clothes. I think one maybe has like 8 hooks or so. They can accommodate a lot of clothes. So there's no reason why you shouldn't have this. So something else that I have been using and has been so helpful, my God. You know how you're feeling so inconvenienced about something and you're just like, you're at the point where it's like you almost want to start inventing stuff. Inventions come out of what? Inconvenience. I don't know how they put that thing, but it sounds like it makes sense. I would want to put water into the bucket, and then the water wasn't going into the bucket directly from the tap. So I was just thinking like, and then I said, let me go online, and then I was searching for tap extenders, and then I found this one. It made me so happy. I got it, I attached it to the tap, and it worked like a dream. You can also use this if you have children that are too small to reach over to the wash hand basin and you want them to be able to wash their hands comfortably. But you can use this on certain kind of taps, not on like the long, I don't think you can use it on those long taps, but if you have, you know, wash hand basin taps or bath taps, you can use this. And I think I got this for 700 naira or 1000 naira. It wasn't more than 1000 naira. So something else I really, really love, oh my God, I'm going to look for the page I got this from, because I got this a while ago. It's called Tablemate. I'm sure a lot of people have heard of it. I have seen the ones that people use on the bed. So they look like this breakfast, this thing that people used to bring you breakfast in bed. But this one, I had never seen this one before. And I just saw it on this page. I was like, I actually need something like this. So it slides underneath like your bed, your sofa. And I like the fact that you can close it up and it's just flat. You can just slide it in somewhere, so it doesn't take up space, because I mean, you don't want something that you would get for convenience and then it's also taking up so much space. It's like you went to buy a problem for yourself, or you sorted out one problem and then you created another problem for yourself. So I like the fact that it is very, very versatile. You can use it in your living room, in your bedroom, you can use it to eat, you can use it to work, you can use it to write, whatever you want to use it for. It makes it so convenient. It will serve you well. You will enjoy it. So something else that makes me so happy. This is something that I use on a daily basis. So you can imagine, like, whenever I want to use it, I'm smiling because I'm just like, I solved such a huge problem. And I got this about 3 weeks ago. I feel like I should just open an affiliate link with this website because a lot of people might want to buy this thing and I can make some money off it. I got this cable hook. I'll call it a cable hook or a cable organizer. Now, I know there are different types. There are the ones that you can just fold your cable in and put them there like a box. But this one fits the purpose that I needed it for. I needed something to just hang my wires on because I use my laptop a lot and I don't want to have to, you know, loosen up my wire and then start to plug and all of that. I just wanted a case where I sit on my work table, I just drag the wire out neatly from wherever I was parked, plug in, use, hang back. And initially I was thinking of putting a command hook. I told you guys I love command hooks. I was thinking of putting a command hook on my table, but then I said, you know what, let me just go online. And so I went to a lot of sites. Actually, I went to Google, found that I could get on Amazon and AliExpress, but I knew that with the situation of things, it wouldn't have been easy or shipping would have been delayed. And so I went on conga.com and then I typed it in, and the price itself, I was like, how is it this cheap? I think I saw it for like 1,000. It was 1,500 naira. It comes with an adhesive bag, so you peel off the sticker behind, you stick it where you want, and then bam, use it. I have moved it a couple of times because I've moved my work table from one place to another and then I've had to change the position. I would say don't move it too much. Even though I've moved it like 3-4 times, it's still stuck on there and it is really, really strong. It's almost like pop socket. It works like pop socket, but the adhesive is a lot stronger. I just attach my wires onto it, my phone wire, my laptop wire, my watch wire, and then they're all connected to my extension. And so when I want to use any of this, I just extend, plug in. When I'm done, I remove, and then I just hang back. And it just makes life so easy. It makes you enjoy the process of whatever it is that you're doing, and it gives you one less thing to worry about. So the last thing on my list is a spoon rest. And you guys know, sometimes I'm cooking in bulk, I'm making stew, I'm making soup, I'm boiling meat. And of course, you don't want to have to rinse one spoon after the other to enter one pot, rinse another spoon to enter that pot. So you will definitely be using multiple spoons. Now, I know that the spoon rests that people sell, the regular ones I see are like the big round ones that are made in the shape of a spoon. But then, even though I have that one, when I got it, I kept on thinking, like, how practical is this? This is good for one spoon, but when I'm cooking with more than one spoon, how do I do it? Do I put my soup spoon on my stew spoon? Do I put my stew spoon on my soup spoon? Do I have to rinse both spoons before I put them there? So using the big one really is not the most realistic thing for me. I found this one, and even though I think in the ad or in the picture, it said you can use it to store your cooking spoons. So what I use this for is that when I cook, I put each spoon in between the spaces that were given. I think it takes like 4 spoons or so. And this just makes it so easy because it has like a small tray where you have all the food, all the food on the spoon just kind of drips down there. So when you lift it up to stir again, you've had all your excess pour out, and then you can lift up the spoon without having any drips, and then you just stir all over again. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Just let me know that small item that was so inexpensive that you bought in your house and has made such a huge difference to your daily living. Because all of these things I just mentioned, they make such a huge difference in my life, as small and as cheap as they are. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.